Hello, hello, everybody. Happy Friday and welcome, welcome. How is everyone doing tonight? We have a just chatting stream tonight. It's going to be very chill. It's going to be very chill vibes type stream tonight. Thank you, thank you. I appreciate it. Do you like it? I worked very hard on it. Your girl has about 0% creativity, so pulling this together takes a little bit more than a creative person would be able to do.
You're lost again?
All right. Cat?
Hello.
We have a cafe date.
Yeah.
Underdressed. Kat is very spiff for just going to the coffee shop today.
But this is what I always wear.
Around the house as well. Do you sit in front of your PC in a suit jacket but no pants?
I mean, yeah.
This is where I get my jiggle physics, is from the pudding. Wait, Kat pointed this out to me just before stream, and I didn't even realize, I did not do this intentionally, but look at the pudding, look at the pudding, look, 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 look. It jiggles with me. Or it did. Look at it go! Yeah! This is where I get my jiggle physics from. I eat jiggly pudding. Or flan.
Maybe it's a creme caramel.
Whatever it is, this is where I get my jiggle physics from. I eat jiggly pudding.
Although it's got a cherry on it, maybe not.
Yes, we bought a few of those in Final Fantasy. 9 being my favorite one. They just kind of go upside down and they jiggle jiggle. Flan. Birthday flan. If you know, you know. Right. So you guys put so many cool questions and random questions and interesting questions in my Discord. It is not too late to do so. If you so desire to ask a question, you can still go ahead and put it in the Discord. I have a AMA for stream channel in there if you want to. Yes, Winston do be sponsoring the questions for this whole stream. My money don't jiggle jiggle. It's gone. Well, it's going to be a very chill type stream today. We haven't done one of these in a minute. If you are a veteran in my chat, we've done a duck stream, which was a just chatting stream. And for Valentine's Day, we did a like a romantic date type thing, like a date with amethyst type thing. That was actually a lot of fun. We had a good time that night. Right. <Yeah. laughs> You were very spiff that day, Kat.
Yeah, I had a bow.
A bow, very properly dressed. Yeah. So let's start. Start at the start, shall we? Right. I have not prepared for this. What made you want to become a streamer? Ooh, classic question. So I have lived in a few countries now. I have lived in 4 countries and several states, and I found myself landed in England, and this actually answers a future question as well. I went to school here. I did my I did my psychology training here. So that was a lot of fun, but I do not have a visa to work here. It's so complicated. Visas are the worst thing in the world, and they are the scourge of the earth. So so I don't have a visa to actually work here. Too complicated, too expensive, not worth it. So, since I am trained to be a therapist, but I cannot work being a therapist in this country. hi, Lucius. Since I cannot be a therapist in this country, the only interesting source of income that I could think of was to stream. Because technically, I stream, quote unquote, from the US. So I get paid in US dollars. It goes through my US taxes. I mean, everything done through Twitch is all through my American credentials, even though I am physically in another country, which is the beauty of streaming, that I can actually do that. And it's very nice. And I enjoy it. I love you guys. And to be honest, when I started this, and this comes at a perfect time after I just had my celebration for 1,000 followers, that I, honest to goodness, Clay, back me up here. I thought for sure that my streaming career would be one of those that I would be streaming to five people and barely making it by the entire time. I did not think that I had the personality for this. I did not think I had the voice for this. I would say that I didn't think I had the skill in video games, but I still definitely don't.
No.
But I do my best. Chat is one person with many logins. One person has over 1,000 Twitch accounts and they all follow me. Yes, exactly. Clay put it very nicely. Hopeful, but definitely not expecting it. Definitely not. 100%. So much bully potential. That's perfect. Oh, Winston is the only right one because he's a chicken. You have to do that thing with your feet on your keyboard so that you could type. I'm mind leader. Beautiful. Kat, why are you a streamer?
I'm not. You just told me to come in and I did.
If any were curious, Kat is actually part of my brand. That VTuber model is commissioned to me, and we were meant to be a VTuber pair. So, canonically, is that a word? Canonically, Kat is actually my cat.
What's it canonic?
Something being canon.
Oh, what now?
Your lore is that you are my cat.
But I'm not a cat.
Oh, I'm sorry. Not M cat. Yeah. Canonically is a word.
That's too big brain for this stream.
Accurate. So, yes, Cat just kind of showed up because he's my cat and I'm the one that has treats in my pocket. So he just kind of follows me where I go.
Yeah, and I don't get any treats.
Before Cat, I had Shoulder Cat. Here, allow me. Shoulder Cat. This is Shoulder Cat. This was, quote unquote, my cat before I had Cat.
That one's much better looking.
Oh, he's very handsome.
Yeah. I'm just your running your mill. Just, yeah.
Uh-huh. He does kind of look sassy, doesn't he? She?
Which one?
Well, you are sassy. This one just looks sassy. You are contrary to your image because you look very dapper and smart and well-dressed. But you're kind of a dick.
Well endowed? Yes. I like these phrases that we're coming up with.
He's not sassy. He's just British. I love this. But yeah, that's Shoulder Cat. That was the OG cat before cat was cat.
Not damn cat.
Not damn cat. I'm very sorry. Let's see. How did you meet Not M Cat and all of the others? And what is your favorite memory with them? I love this question. Oh my gosh. So Cat and Siege, and Clay for that matter, I met them through Final Fantasy XIV, if you can believe that. It was actually quite beautiful. Siege and Clay and I met through a mutual friend at the time who actually ended up being kind of an asshole. So we stopped being friends with that guy. And then the two of us just kind of like vibed. Yeah, him. We remember him. Yeah, he ended up being pretty toxic. So we dropped that particular friend. But Clay, Siege, and I, we kind of still had that vibe. And we're kind of like, you know, Chatty Cathy types. So we stayed friends even after we didn't have that mutual friend anymore. So that was nice. And that's been, what, a couple of years now, right, since then? I think so. Which is beautiful. Oh, God. And you haven't killed me yet. Started as a friend, became bestie, then became a mod, and you still haven't murdered me in-game. Cat?
Yeah?
We actually met through a Savage raid. So there was I one night living in France, and I
That's
decided...
That's not true.
I didn't even say anything yet. What?
You are misremembering.
Okay, go on then. You tell the story.
We met through Hades Extreme.
Yes, that's where I was going. There was I one night in France by myself, and
it's
I
not
happened
a savage
to...
raid, I... bruh. Don't get things twisted,
bruh.
You follow were mediocre the plot line. Savage at best.
So there was I one night living in France. And I was bored, so I got into a random party for Hades Extreme. And it was new content at the time, and people were failing at it pretty hard. So I got into this one party that just so happened to have a healer spot open up.
Noobs.
Oops.
Noobs.
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 And it turned out the leader of that party had his own Savage Raid group. And he got close to me and we became friends. And he, blood for the blood lily. Yes. So he and I became friends and we hung out. And eventually he was like, you're a pretty healer. So do you want to be a part of my Savage Raid group? And I was like, yeah, sure, fuck it, let's go. And that was over New Year's 2019. So then I became a part of his Savage Raid group, and I was his regular healer. And Kat was our red mage?
Yeah.
Yeah. I know, right? So Kat and I met through a Savage Raid group. And we've been friends ever since. Or he's been my the red mage fits the cat. I mean, yeah. So yeah, we met through that group. And we've been friends ever since. Since late 2019. Out of all of the cronies that I have here on stream, I have known Kat the longest. And I haven't killed him yet in-game. Savage raids are the hardest content in...
No,
this is going to be a difficult stream, isn't it? Okay.
Well, if you keep giving false information, it is for sure.
Okay. Second hardest content that you can run in Final Fantasy XIV. There are 8-man groups, 2 tank, 2 healer, 4 DPS, and it's hard content. It requires a lot of cooperation, so you have to be really coordinated with your team. Let's see. And then there's Kaz. Kaz actually was my very first fan. Even before my debut, he was up on my TikTok announcement for my debut, and he was wishing me luck, and then he was there for my actual debut. He was my most active chatter for my debut stream, and then he started playing some of my very first games with me on stream, and he got up into my voice chat and we started talking and we had a lot of fun playing these games together, and he did a lot. He's actually done a real lot for me, and I am eternally grateful. And he's been a huge supporter of me ever since, and we got to being friends. So Kaz and I have been friends for 9 months now. Is that right? 8? However long I've been streaming, plus a little bit, that's how long I have been friends with Kaz. It is about 9, isn't it, Clay? God, look at what we built. Now here I am, sat in a cafe talking to chat. Which, honestly, I never thought that I would do a just chatting stream, to be honest. My social anxiety cannot. I need at least something else, like a game going. Like, literally just sitting here and talking for a couple hours is, like, anxiety-inducing. But I'm fine. I'm fine. And then there's Jeremy. Jeremy actually came about halfway through my stream career. He inserted himself into one of my Warframe streams. November. Yes, thank you. He came into a spot that I had open. I think Kat was working a big boy job that day. And he was like, can I hop in your voice chat? And normally I never do that because I've had nothing but the worst experiences with having random people come into my voice chat. But in this particular night, I was just kind of like, fuck it. The recent, most recent victim of the unpaid mod committee. Mm-hmm. So then this Hungarian accent comes up into my chat, and I'm like, I think I still want to keep listening to that. So, through streaming and all of this, we got to be friends as well. So that's been since the end of last year. Let him stay for the accent. Exactly. Let's see. How'd you come up with the name Amethyst for the stream handle? Ooh, I like this. So Amethyst was actually made without a name. She didn't have a name at all when she was actually commissioned and designed. Riso, who is my VTuber artist, she was made with sparkly hair. I didn't even ask her specifically for any colors, but she made purple sparkly hair, and she went off of my, what do you call that? Reference photos for like the clothing and stuff like that. But she designed the hair entirely on her own, and she picked the color for it. And I was just like, you know what? That's fucking bitchin'. That is amazing. I love that. So It was one of those things where I just stared and stared and stared at her after she got her color. And I'm like, you know what that looks like? That looks like amethyst. I loved it. So thus was born the name amethyst. And since that's extremely common, painfully so, I put on Astra at the end of that. And so that became the celestial cat girl type thing. And how about you, Kat? Why are you...
Weird purple thing.
Weird purple thing. Kat, why are you not M. Kat?
I mean, I'm a cat.
But you're not M. Kat.
No, but I am M. Kat.
Right. So why the name not M. Kat?
Because it wouldn't let me have M. Kat.
Wait, M. Kat was taken?
Yeah, and I was sad, so I put not M. Kat.
Oh, so now you're not M. Kat.
Yeah.
Even though you're a cat.
Yeah.
Nice. M. sometimes cat. Sometimes.
Yeah.
Not like, always.
And when people take my name, I'm not M. Kat.
Yeah. Is that why you are M. Kat in the Discord? Because it wasn't taken.
Yeah, but nobody knows. They have to guess, you see.
Oh, I see. We have to guess whether or not you are indeed a cat.
Yeah, some days I might be, some days I might not be.
So when you're not M. Kat, what are you?
Well, that's for you to guess.
Okay. Oh, now we're in the biggie questions from Winston. This is awesome. Okay, here we go.
Uh-oh.
Why did you become a VTuber instead of a normal streamer? What about me suggests normal to you? Well, for the same reason I play video games. I like to... Yes, the privacy is nice. I have a multi-layered answer to this. I like to be able to look at myself, like how I'm looking through my OBS right now. Or, for instance, when I'm on VR chat, I look in the mirror when I'm playing a game, what I see. I like to see something that is realistically impossible. Like, as much as I would love to have cat ears and a tail and have my hair be purple and sparkly and have melons this big with a teeny tiny waist and things like this, realistically, it's impossible. And I don't like reality. I don't. I have played far too many video games in my life, and I like what is impossible. So this is quite nice. I like this a lot. I much prefer this over my real face. I'm not an ugly girl, by any means. I think I'm quite cute, but quite frankly, amethyst is much better. How about you, Kat? Why are you a cat?
I don't know, you told me to come here and be a cat, so I was.
Okay, well, you chose the design for cat, so why are you like this?
Because I started off as Hajiki.
That's true, yes.
And I took on good persona of Hajiki.
Uh-huh.
So, I'm Kat.
Why the suit?
Well, it's very important.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
That's it. It's just important.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's most important. Mm-hmm. You have to look smart.
Oh, must look smart.
But it's got sort of agent vibes to it. Like,
are you the FBI? Like,
I could be the FBI, I could be the Men in Black, I could be some other government agency. You just don't know, you see. Because possibly AMCAT, but possibly not AMCAT. You know, you just don't know. Espionage.
If you're the FBI, you haven't seen my search history, have you?
I kind of have, and it's mildly alarming.
I'm not KGB. Chat's on fire tonight. Okay. MI5? Are you MI5?
No, I'm MI6.
Meow I5?
Meow I6.
What is the reason you started streaming mostly Warframe instead of other games? So it started off as numbers. Cat Hem Black. I started off with a bunch of things. I started off with, let's see, Deep Rock Galactic. What else did I play? Kingdoms Reborn. There was a lot of stuff that I kind of experimented with. Sunhaven. I intended originally to be a mostly cozy game streamer because, if I'm honest, that's where my comfort lies, really. I like city builders. Oh, Palia! Yes, I started with Palia. I was in the open beta for Palia, and that was a lot of fun. That was a lot of good early streamer experience where I could make my mistakes. And then I started streaming Warframe, and I noticed that it had a lot of attention on it. And I noticed that the people that were coming into the stream and talking to me in chat were like the coolest people. I mean, almost everybody here is from my Warframe streams, except for maybe like my really, really, really veterans like Don or Kaz. That's, you know what, I think, Lilith, I think that's exactly what it is. I think even though my interests and my likes might fall on a cozy game, I think my personality for streaming might be better suited for something a little more chaotic. Exactly, exactly. I would not have come across you guys without Warframe streaming, so it's actually really nice. I'm very thankful for it. That's where almost all of my growth has come from. I really did not have a whole lot of viewers, a lot of chatters, a lot of anything before I started Warframe. So it started off as I want to do this for growth type thing. But it kind of migrated to it suiting my personality and the people that it brought in. Because obviously, you guys are awesome. Kat?
Mm? Yeah.
Why do you play Warframe?
I was recommended Warframe by an old friend of mine that I've never met in real life, like most
mm-hmm.
people.
Mm-hmm.
And so I started playing Warframe about 8 years ago.
Ooh.
And I've played Warframe on and off since then.
Mm-hmm.
And it scratched an itch that I often get that most games can't, because I'm very picky when it comes to games.
Yes.
I have a certain thing where they have to really hold my attention and they have to have a lot to do.
Mm-hmm.
Or a lot of like, it's really, I'm kind of weird. Like,
I know.
I like really repetitive, grindy games where you have to do a lot for very little.
ADHD.
I mean, yeah, possibly.
Possibly not ADHD.
Yeah. So yeah, I started playing and it kept me hooked. But obviously, like, when you get everything, you kind of step back from it and take a little break.
Mm-hmm.
And then you come back and do it all over again.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But kind of recently, I've just been keeping up to date with every update because it has been gaining a lot of traction.
Mm-hmm.
Warframe, it used to be kind of a niche game that only a certain few played.
Mm-hmm.
But obviously their studio is gaining a lot of momentum and mm-hmm. the quality of their content is quite incredible at the moment. So yeah, it's just a game that I've always followed and I will continue to do so because it's becoming something quite incredible.
I was just going to say it, Clay. I was just going to say it. The worse Destiny does, the better Warframe does. I've said that before on stream, and I'm going to die on that hill.
Destiny 1 was an incredible game, and mm-hmm. I have many, many, many fond memories from doing all the raids in that game and things like that. But Destiny 2 didn't scratch that itch, mainly because early on I joined a raid team to do whatever the raid was, the first one. Was it the... I don't remember names. I'm not good with names. And that kind of went toxic, that relationship. So, no, the first raid in Destiny 2, play. So, like, I joined a different raid group to do that because I don't like pugging raids because it's you kind of get to know people and yeah, Leviathan. That's what I was thinking of. But yeah, it all went sour and it kind of put a sour taste in my mouth for that game. And I'm kind of glad it did because at the end of the day, the game kind of went downhill pretty quickly. So yeah, just a little rant now. But...
I'm sorry, I can't hear you over my fish.
I've noticed.
Right, questions. Anyway. Oh, it's raining in the cafe. Shit.
Oh. Do we have a leak?
My pudding. Must be a leak. How and where did you find the artists for your avatar? Honestly? Fiverr. Not kidding. Literally every single thing I have ever done, whether it's my border, my advertisement videos, my avatar, my rigging, everything. Everything is done through Fiverr. Fiverr is indeed loaded. I support small artists. I find it to be very important to support people that are not big. I get this way about streamers and I get this way about artists. If you see the raids that I do, I try to find people that are on the smaller side, as much as I can anyway. But Fiverr being the same way. For instance, and I'm not getting into any kind of certain topic here when I say this, but I commissioned my model in a time where maybe hiring a Ukrainian artist might have been a good idea, is all I'm going to say on that particular topic. But she was amazing. She's absolutely fantastic. And obviously she does really good work. She's also a complete sweetheart. And, you know, when you get messages that say, I'm sorry, your delivery is going to be just a day late. I'm sorry, there's rockets or whatever the word that she used for it. Like, obviously, I want to support that person. But in general, I support small artists, you know, especially people that are just trying to get their start and very obviously have a lot of unbridled talent, which very obviously she does. And Max as well. Max, my rigger, is an absolute sweetheart. He's actually working on something for me right now. Obviously, incredibly talented. Look at my hair. He did my hair. Like, it just, it flows. It's beautiful. It's gorgeous. Like, who does that? I tried doing this once. I tried downloading Live 2D Cubism. Is that the correct word? And I am a very patient person, but oh, I gave up. Oh, I gave up. That was too much. Your girl tried to do it on her own. I tried to be big girl, independent. I can do it myself. No. That was terrible. So that was not my thing. All the better, because they are absolutely incredible people. All of the beautiful official art that comes out, that's all from her. All of my rigging is done through Max. He's amazing. Liquid GTX, who made my border here, which is normally purple. I changed the color of it for today. Absolutely incredible. Absolutely everybody is through Fiverr. So that's me supporting small artists. Oh. Why aren't you, Jeremy, if you think that you have the patience for that and you want to rig boobs, you go for it. You go for it, babes. I support you, but you will not find your girl doing it is what I'm saying. It's extremely hard. No, you won't get paid. it's extremely complicated. It's very, very hard, and it's even harder to do right. It's a pain. It's a real pain. why aren't you giving Kat his nuggies? Kat?
Yeah.
What have you done to deserve nuggies?
We've been through this. I'm owed so many.
Mm-hmm.
And you're not giving me a good reason why I can't have them.
Because it's a beautiful bit that Kat never gets his nuggies. Although if you will view the Not Safe for Work channel in my Discord, you will see that Kat did kind of get his nuggies in some form.
I can't eat them, though. they're too big.
The nuggies got Kat. Verimar was there. let's see. What does a chicken have to do to take you out? Legalize bestiality. What? babes, you want nothing to do with me. I am an absolute nightmare.
Yeah.
Did you just say yeah?
Yeah.
Oh. I'm into nightmares. I just had a nightmare last night about aliens. I'm not even kidding. That's not even a bit. It was so weird. Drags his ass out of bed every day and puts up with your shit. He needs nugs.
I need a stockpile at this point.
Right? That's it. That's exactly it, Verimar. I'm the I can fix her girl. I can make her worse. Clay. Oh my gosh. Why did you decide to live in the UK for such a long time? Covered this one a bit. I live somewhat nomadically? Is that a word? I live a very nomadic life. And I live in a different country every few years or something. Actually, the UK I've been in for probably the longest. I think I lived in Canada for a year. I was in France for a year and a half. So this one's actually a long one. But to answer your question directly, pure laziness and lack of funds, really. Moving country is a beast. It is such a massive undertaking. So doing such things is very difficult. Oh, hello, hello, and welcome to whatever this is. I appreciate the raid. How was your stream, dear? I hope you had a good one. And a happy Friday to you as well. I hope you have really awesome weekend plans. I plan on being a gremlin. How about you? Let's see. Where was I? Oh, so I've been in the UK for a hot minute now. And I completely lost my train of thought. What was I saying?
You're a gremlin.
I am a gremlin.
I'm a gremlin too.
You're a gremlin too. Gremlin cat. When not am cat, am gremlin. I've been everywhere. And I've been here for a while. Not am gremlin. But without getting too into really personal stuff, my mother was a nightmare, and she just died. So I would be able to move back home to the United States, maybe back to New Jersey or somewhere similar that I would be able to actually live in without fear of her, basically, is what that is. Again, not getting too terribly personal, but I guess I have to stop at Winston's house before I move back overseas. Do you live in a chicken coop, Winston? Is it a coop that you live in? I will visit your coop. Hey, hey, hey. Why do they call it a chicken coop?
Because it ain't a sedan.
Oh, wait, no, no, I fucked it up. Hang on, wait, no. It's, why does a chicken coop have two doors?
Because it's not a chicken sedan.
Ha ha, because if it had four doors, it would be a chicken sedan.
Okay, I've had enough of this now. I'll see you later.
I'll see myself out. I love it. Let's see. What are the biggest surprises you have encountered after living in other countries? I love this. This is gorge. This is a gorgeous question. I miss home. As much shit as the United States gets on like social media and stuff, I miss it after living in Europe, if I'm brutally honest. So let's see. When I lived in Canada, I was very surprised that putting A at the end of a sentence is actually a real thing. That is not a bit. So real. They actually put A at the end of their sentences. I also learned that in one section of Canada, Quebec, French is the first language, and there are laws around that language. They have language laws. I had no idea. For instance, things like if you have a sign in Quebec that French has to be the first language and it has to be bigger than the subsequent English underneath. It's things like that. I had no idea such things existed. And it was so bonkers and so interesting to me, but I guess that's the way that they want to preserve their French heritage. And that's interesting. That's very interesting. Obviously a little backward sounding to someone who comes from a country that speaks one language, mostly. But I thought that was very interesting. And then when I lived in France, I was very surprised how things are run, like what you see on social media about things like the protests and stuff. French protest a lot. Like, a lot. There would be days that you couldn't go out because the like the public transport, they were on strike, that it was not advised to go into the city because the Yellow Jackets were out, that my roommate at the time, he couldn't go to school for like 2 months because the staff of his school were all protesting. And it's the strangest thing. I don't know how anything functions. But even when everybody is doing their thing as they are meant to, that everything shuts down in the middle of the day. Coming from America, the most capitalist country ever. Like, if a business just shut down entirely for several hours in the middle of the day, they wouldn't be able to survive. But I did notice this, that I think one time was even just like something as simple as a plant shop. I wanted to go buy a plant for my room. And it was like 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and the sign out front said that they were closed from like 10 to 2 or something like that. And I was told that this is actually extremely common, that in the middle of the day, that businesses will just stop. As an American, this is very interesting. Am I boring you, Kat?
Huh?
I do not speak one word of French. I lived there for a year and a half. I retained nothing. I can say hello, goodbye, please, thank you, excuse me, and is your sister over 18? That's all I know. Cat was dozing. Am I boring you with my ranting?
No, it's when I look down, it looks like I'm asleep.
Uh-huh. You're looking down with your eyes closed and snoring.
No, I'm making my cat a little hat.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Because I'm bisexual, Winston. He's on his phone, no doubt. Let's see, what else? Now England. Oh, I have plenty of things to say about England. The first thing that I noticed about England was how people ask how somebody is. If you go to your neighbor outside and instead of like in an American way and you say, hi, how are you? People say, are you all right? La baguette. To be fair, the bakeries in France is literally everything that they say. Like, the bread and the sandwiches in France are like, oh my god, they're actually so fucking good.
But the thing with the English, are you all right, it's all one word.
Go on, then.
You're right.
Yeah, this. It's just something. So the first time I just had like a very random person ask me how I am, and they said, help me out, Kat.
Yeah, right.
That. I was like, as an American, I'm thinking, I'm fine. Am I bleeding somewhere that I don't know of or something? Because when you say, as an American, are you all right? That's kind of implying, oh, something's wrong. Like, are you good? You know? So it's different. It's just different. That and the weather. The weather is every bit as the stereotype is. It does constantly rain, except for like a few days out of the whole year. It is constantly overcast, even if it isn't raining. It is pretty cold, except for like maybe a week or two in the summer. And then that like week or two is brutally hot and sunny. It's so brutal.
Yeah, it gets worse.
What's your top place to visit next?
Oh, Okay. Thank you, Kaz. Holy shit. That was incredible. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I guess I'm coming to visit you, aren't I? Let's see. Where would I want to visit? Dun, 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 dun. I would like to see my roots, to be honest with you. I would like to see Ireland. I would love to see Germany.
There's not a lot to see in Ireland. Ireland's okay.
Isn't it pretty?
Yeah, it is. There's a few places that are really nice. But there's also a few places that aren't.
I want to see Germany. The only bit of Germany that I have ever seen is the inside of Munich Airport for a layover. That's the closest I got to Germany.
I disagree with that statement, War.
I'd love to see Germany. Portugal? I'd like to see Portugal.
Portugal's nice.
Kat's been to Portugal, and I hear the most beautiful stories, and I really want to see it now.
Yeah, I've been to Portugal about 5 times now.
Really? Is it nice?
It's nice, yeah. It's really nice. It's just a different pace of life. It's just kind of sketchy at night. You don't want to go walking around places.
Yeah.
In certain areas, it's rather nice.
Yeah.
I'd love to go to Japan, but I hear that it's very difficult if you're not fluent. It's very difficult to get around because nobody speaks any English whatsoever.
Oh, oof.
So, it's still on the bucket list, though.
Japan in the spring. That's another one. I would love to see Japan in the spring. They would hate me over there.
I'd also like to go to Vietnam.
You know, you have to be careful around what flavor of American you say that around, especially the older ones. But I do hear that Vietnam is a gorgeous country.
Like, yes, there was a war. Yes, it was horrific. Yes, there were two sides. But, you know, it's such a beautiful country, and it's yes there is a history there, but that shouldn't stop you from wanting to visit places in the world. It's like I'd love to go and see the pyramids, but that part of the world is just far too dangerous.
I do hear that is a little sketchy to do if you're planning on doing that. Dubai, that's somewhere that Kat wanted to go, wasn't it? Didn't you want to see Dubai?
I'd like to go to Dubai. I'd love to go and watch the F1 there. That's like a dream of mine. There or Monaco. Oh, Monaco would be great too.
There are a lot of expats that go to Dubai. It is very expensive there.
I don't think it is. I think it's just got a reputation for having a lot of, like, you know, because of all the what do you call them, sheikhs? Is that what they are? The very rich, like, royals. But like, I don't think it's like out of reach for the common person to go to Dubai.
Is it not?
No. It's very hot. It's extremely hot, but I'd love to go. I'd love to go. Long flight though.
I had this and it was gorgeous. And then I fucked it up. Don't mind me. Okay. It looks like we're going to be bright now.
I'm trying to think of other places that I'd like to go to.
Reykjavik.
Oh, Switzerland. I'd love to go and I'd love to go to Switzerland.
Yeah.
So that's another good one.
Jeremy. Entirely true. Let's all take a group trip. Chocolate. When I was living in France, I had a Belgian friend that came visit.
Belgian chocolate's where it's at.
He brought
never mind Swiss chocolate. Belgian chocolate is where it's at.
He brought me some, and oh, have you ever had a sexual reaction to food?
Yes.
It was like that. This boy, he was so sweet. Oh my God. He brought me legitimate Belgian chocolate. Because I had invited him over for Thanksgiving. I was making a whole Thanksgiving thing with my roommate at the time. He had to cut the head off of a chicken a turkey. It was a whole thing. It was a whole thing because they're very obviously not equipped for a Thanksgiving dinner in France. But never, Winston, never, never. We kind of made do as best we could. And I invited him and he's like, yeah, sure, I'll hop in a train. And he came over and he brought Belgian chocolate and it was...
Yeah, salted chocolate's nice.
Mm.
It's just like salted caramel.
Yeah. Something. Just that little bit of salt in there is really nice.
I did try one that was pretty extreme though. It had legit salt granules in, and that was a bit too much.
Is too much.
There is nice ones.
Mm.
Oh, Belgian truffles though. Oh.
Okay, let's see. What are your future plans or goals for your streaming career? I would like it if I was able to get to a point where I could live off of streaming. And I'm not greedy, right? Like, making what is the equivalent of minimum wage would be perfectly fine for me, seriously. It's difficult where you live in a country that you can't work. And therefore, of course, you have no money, but you can't move back to your home country where you can work because you have no money. And it's just, you need a lot of connections in order to do it. And you need to have people on both sides to help you out. And it's a beast. It's a beast to move country. So it's very, very difficult to do that. So I would be more than happy as a goal, to make what is the equivalent of minimum wage from streaming. And I don't think it's entirely unfair to say that because I only stream 3 hours, 3 days a week, because there is a lot of work that goes on behind the scenes in order to make it work. It's very difficult to explain. It's a lot of work. I put in a lot of hours outside of actual stream time. I put my heart and soul into this, which is why I appreciate your guys' support so much, because it does make it worth it for me. And just because my chat is awesome. Hi, Hyber. And just because
Time well spent.
Time well spent. You know all those many hours that I put in? Yeah, that's what I get for it. Tits being broken every time. Can one of my mods please refund Tiber so that he can hit me again in game? One moment, please. Vamp for me, cat, while I restart my tits.
I'll talk about what I want from streaming.
Okay, go on.
So I'd just like to get paid. Yeah, pretty much. That's my goal.
That's then it.
Maybe I can retire. Because this old body just don't do it anymore. I'm waiting for Ami to like buy me a condo and
okay, just
like live out my days as an old cat.
An old cat. You are an old cat.
I am.
Home ownership is not something that I mean, millennials, we can't own houses. If we haven't yet by 30, we're not gonna. Please help me. I don't want to rent for the rest of my life. Oh, God. Right. Okay. Tits is fixed. So that should be working now. Do you know that my name is not Winston? I did have an inkling that your name was not Winston? What is your favorite food? Would you be horribly offended if I actually said that it was chicken? Who is your favorite chicken? Hey, hey. I'm not flirting with you. I mean, hey, hey. You know, the one from Moana. The, like, actual dipshit chicken that is just, like, incredible. What's your favorite food, Kat?
I like lots of food. I'm not a particularly picky eater like you.
I'm a horribly picky eater.
So you put something in front of me, I'll generally eat it.
Favorite food, yes.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, Clay's got it about right there. So, I mean, if I had to pick something, I do like a good steak if it's cooked well and it's a good piece of meat. And then obviously we're going to have to go with Dauphinoise potatoes.
Ooh, Dauphinoise. That's delicious.
Let's see. I like a good burger too.
Ooh, burgers.
Burger, yeah. Some nice, like, buttermilk chicken tendies. do you remember that time that we went for lunch?
Uh-huh.
You and I.
Uh-huh.
And we got those chicken tendies.
Uh-huh.
And they had that buttermilk and honey dressing stuff, like dip.
What, it was like the buttermilk and honey type thing.
That's what I said.
Yeah. Yeah, that was fucking good.
Yeah.
For those that don't know, Kat and I know each other in real life. We live in the same town.
What else do we like? Have I named too many foods?
No, keep going. Go on. You imagined me as a vegetarian? I couldn't possibly. I love chicken. I don't eat fish. I can't. Other than like tuna from a can, I actually can't really eat fish.
Oh, coffee sauce on a steak. That's a good one.
Coffee sauce?
Yeah. It's very tasty.
What is coffee sauce for a steak?
Well, it's a bit like a peppercorn sauce, but with coffee. And believe me, if you haven't tried it, it's amazing.
I could never imagine coffee and steak together.
It really works. It really works.
Coffee sauce.
Ooh, I'm hungry.
I kind of want food, to be honest, though. Oh, Phantom, that's so cute. Cat, you're getting pets.
I get pets?
You get pets.
Oh.
Go on, like you're getting pet. Go on, like this.
Wait, no, I have a button for this. Wait.
Wait.
It's not often today.
I need food.
It's not, oh, excuse me. It's not often that I get to do this.
No ads! You're going to have to do that again in 50 seconds.
Oh, it's fine. I can get 50 seconds worth of pets too.
Oh, thank you for the follow, Phantom. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh. Ads, what ads? Does it get the spot?
Yes.
That's where I pet my cats, like, right, like, you know, above the eyes, in between, you know? One cat goes bonkers for it.
Top of the snoot.
Top of the snoot, yeah.
Yeah, we like this. We like this. Yeah. It's the good stuff.
Oh my gosh, Phantom, you're living my life. What the hell? Boop the snoot. Feed the chickens.
Okay, that's enough. Oh, excuse me. That's enough.
Wait, no, the ad just ended. Now you have to do it. Go on.
I got a pet again?
Yeah. There was ads.
No,
he said that his daughter was... excuse me. There you go. There. We pet the cats. Aww. Do you purr? Daughter. Right. What else do we have here? My fiance gets home. Teacher. Ooh. Oh, that's so sweet. I love s'mores. Can't do shit like that where I live.
You like anything sweet?
I do. I have the worst sweet tooth in the whole world. Which is why I like chat so much. Aww. Okay. Again. What is the reason for the choice in your time slot/day that you stream? This is a good one.
Lines up with cat not working.
It does line up with most people that I have on my streams not working, yes. But when I did my very extensive research on how long and how often one should stream, and it ended up working out for me quite well, really. What's the term? Scarcity? It's basically the same reason that your favorite show is only on once a week. Like, you want people to... How do you explain it? If you stream every day, and you stream for many, 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 many hours every day, then people don't feel like they're missing out on anything by not watching you. Do you know what I mean? It's a scarcity thing. Yes, it me. Hello. Yes, it sounds a little pretentious to put it in the wording that Germanic just did, but yes, that is basically the understanding. And I'm old, so honestly, streaming for like 3 hours is pretty much my limit, especially for it being as late as it is. And I stream late at night because I know that even though I am physically in England, that I have a very large American audience as well. I think it works out very well for me being old. I've got the mommy voice, which I mean, this is the thing. I, in my spare time, if I ever have any, I look for people to raid that are in the Warframe category or VTubers or whatever it may be. And I would never shit talk another streamer, another content creator. But I mean, I think Jeremy can back me up here because he has looked as well. The content that is out there, I never realized exactly how chill I am until I saw other streamers, to be honest with you. So yeah, I'll just leave that at that. When you're looking for people to raid, Jeremy. Yeah, exactly. So I don't mind being old because it makes me more chill and it makes my voice in an octave that is tolerable to listen to for an extended period of time. I'm going to put it that way. I'll put it that way because, again, I don't want to shit talk other creators. So yeah, mostly it is because I'm old, because I have a bedtime, but I want to stream as late as possible. Oh, thank you. I want to stream as late as possible because I also want to include my American audience, which last I checked my statistics was more than half. It's like 60% or something is all Americans. Maybe that's it, War. You know, maybe that's it. Maybe it's trying to grab attention, which, I mean, power to them, because that's what you have to try to do. You know, you do you. But yeah. Yeah, pretty much. What else do we have here? I know, and I stream until usually 11 o'clock at night, which is your girl's bedtime, I assure you. I can't sit in a chair the way that I used to be able to. My back hurts and my old bones hurt after a while, especially because, like I said, my 3-hour stream is not the only time that I work. I spend, at the absolute bare minimum, 2 hours. In front of my PC, trying to stream prep and make sure that everything works, which is fruitless because everything is broken by the time I start streaming anyway. But I do check these things, I do test these things, and at least 2 hours before I am already here. So I do try my best, but I'm old. If I could stream later, I would, especially because what you're saying is actually relevant to numbers as well, because I notice my first hour of stream, I have maybe half the viewers that I have for the rest of the night. My stream actually doesn't even start picking up until about 9 p.m. my time, like around now. Would be when I start really making spends 2 hours making sure stream is working. Ah, fuck, guys, stream stitch is broken. Every time, never fails. But maybe I should stream later. Maybe I should push it like an hour or something, like do a 9 to 12 instead of an 8 to 11. I'll fuck around with it. Let's see. Oh, now we're getting into the good stuff. Why is there a jellyfish but no peanut butter fish? Cat?
Because if you get your peanut butter wet, it just makes a mess.
Isn't peanut butter hydrophobic? Can you even get peanut butter wet? No one likes soggy nuts. Why do you ask Kat so many questions when he's clearly tired?
What?
In the Discord, I'm being asked, why do you ask Kat so many questions when you're clearly tired?
Because otherwise I would sit here being a stream decoration.
People have legitimately thought that because Kat speaks so infrequently, which they didn't understand the shtick, that they thought Kat was a stream decoration. We were doing circuit one day and they're like, oh my god, the cat talks.
I mostly speak when spoken to.
Yes. It's a bit. It's just like a cat. Very rarely speaks, doesn't want anything to do with you, but when it does speak, it's kind of an asshole to you. And that's cats, isn't it? Anyone that has cats knows exactly what the hell I'm talking about.
Yeah.
What do you most regret and wish you could redo?
My life.
Life? Being born? I wish I could talk to my mother from beyond the grave and be like, bro, no, you did it wrong. Try again. You won the whole list. What a question. Oh my gosh.
I honestly wish I could just go back and redo my education. I was kind of a bad kid in school and ended up like hating school, and then by the time I've reached my adult life, I realized that, oh, school is kind of important.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. Probably that's the main one.
You ended up a desk decoration.
Yeah. That gets paid in nothingness.
Mm-hmm. I pay you in appreciation and thighs.
Yeah, that's not enough, bitch.
See? Cats. It's cats. The person that came in didn't understand the shtick. Yeah. Same. If I could be born all over again, but not with my mother, that would be awesome. Redo college time. I think a lot of people would agree. Anybody that's been to college would say, yeah, I wish I could redo college. Yeah, same, to be honest. Same. I like this one. This is the perfect one for the both of us, Kat. Oh, ancient one is how the question starts. Yeah. Do people really get any wiser as they get older?
In your case, no.
Huh?
In my case, yes, very much so.
Oh, are you a very wise cat?
I am.
Is that right?
Yeah.
No. I was fired. I unfortunately had to learn my harsh life lessons when I was quite young. But I guess that means that I was able to carry them into when I got older. So.
Yeah, but you're a good little girl that's been sheltered, so.
And no. I'm a good girl because I am abused. Or was, I was. So that good girl syndrome is, it has its problems. It has its problems. I asked a therapist this once, because if you don't know, therapists have therapists. In fact, they need therapists more than anybody, really. And I asked this question once. I asked her, I said, I never had my wild teenage years. I never had like the, how would you say, the going out and getting drunk and doing something really stupid. I never had the stay out until 2 o'clock in the morning, even though you knew that you would be in a lot of trouble.
two o'clock in the morning.
Things like this, like being brought home by the police, like having them like grab you by the back of your shirt and be like, is this yours? And your parents are like, nope. So I never had that. I was always, they call it good girl syndrome as a layman term. But if you are raised by narcissists, then they will mold you in this way. So I asked my therapist, and now I'm passing this knowledge on to you, my gremlins in my chat. I said, how bad is that, really? Like, the difference between not having your wild, unhinged, troublemaker years versus not. And she told me something that has stuck with me. She said, actually, whenever I have parents that come into my therapy office and they say, oh, little Johnny, you know, he's 15. He's such a good boy. He's very well behaved. He gets straight A's in school. He never gets into any trouble. She says, you know what the first thing is that I think is, honestly, I'm going to see that kid in 10 years here in my therapy office. And I think I'm here to tell you. Yeah, it's true. My life, yeah. Narcissistic mothers, they're the best. Love that. Yeah, you know what? Therapists are the worst patients. Because, honestly, I have a psych degree hanging on my wall with my name on it. And the moment I start to have a panic attack, every word, every letter of that education just falls straight out of my ears. All gone. All gone. And I never know what to do. But if someone else came to me with a panic attack, I would be able to know exactly what to do. But for me... how far does the therapist go before it circles around? It's like an orgy, you know, eventually it just goes all the way around and starts at the beginning again. That's exactly it. Therapy in particular is really interesting because, oh, Jeremy, stop. how do you explain it? Part of the job requirements to be a good therapist is understanding and empathy and compassion, but it goes way too far because it makes it to a point, at least for me, this is my own personal experience, that if somebody does something horrible, instead of saying, oh, that guy's an asshole, I'm going to cut them out, yada, 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 which may or may not be the healthy thing, depending on the situation. Instead, you look for the reason and you try to understand it and you try to help, even if really the best thing for you personally, for the sake of self-preservation, is to get the hell out. So it's really something. It really is. That one got away from me. Okay. What skill would you like to master and why? I'll let Kat answer this one first.
That's tough because there are so many things that I'd like to be able to do. But yeah, Clay's nailed it with the second one there for me. I used to play the drums. I stopped, but I don't know. I just wish I had years of experience doing that. mm-hmm. and I was good at it, but I don't. Mm-hmm. I'd like to be able to draw, yeah.
Oh, I'd love to be able to draw.
I'd like to be a better lover.
Oh. Are you not?
Well, I'm a mediocre lover.
Are we talking about deep conversation and cuddles, or are we talking about peen?
Oh, I'm good at the peen.
Oh, I see.
Like, I'd like to be able to, like, I'm not very good at conversation. I'm kind of autistic, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
So conversation's kind of hard for me.
Yeah.
But, yeah. I don't know why that came out as lover. That's kind of weird.
I mean, I didn't want it to be clear if we were talking about deep conversation and cuddles and time spent, or if we were talking about peen.
Oh, no, we get the deep peen. It's no problem with the peen. It's all good.
Between the sheets is just fine. Outside the sheets is where the trouble starts. Oh, gosh. I go with it. I go with the piano playing. I would give my right tit to be able to play the piano well. I think playing the piano is sexy. Like,
yeah, but then you'd be wonky.
Good point. Okay. I'd give my right knee to be able to
still be wonky.
Half of each tit, I'd put the two remnants together and make one central tit.
A super boob? Just give like half a nipple or something. That should be fine.
Well, no, that's the best part.
All right, give like half an areola.
I would take a nipple reduction. I have big boobs. You know what? Yeah, I would take a reduction. Yeah, because maybe then I wouldn't have fucking back problems. Maybe then I could stand up straight. Not like if I did not actually suffer with like effort. If I stood up, I would just fall forward. I really did. The only thing countering the balance of weight is my fat ass. That's the only thing that balances out the weight, and I have back problems. Okay, I would take a breast reduction if it meant that I could play the piano. Reduction for longer streams. So true, though. Has anyone ever seen, what's that anime? Ragnarok. Record of Ragnarok? You know, Aphrodite, that she sits in that chair. Yes! Jeremy took the words right out of my mouth. The chair that she has, this like stone chair, and instead of arms for the chair, it's literal hands that reach around and grab her boobs and hold it up. I need this. Oh, yes, that's exactly it. If you know a girl that has large booba, the best thing in the world that you can do for her is go up behind her with consent and put your whole hand, palm up under the boobs and just lift and just take the weight off of her for like just a couple minutes. Just stand there. And just do that with consent and just let her feel her spine for once. That is a weight that you never get to escape. It's awful. Where are we?
I'd like to be able to code too. That's another one.
That's so easy for you to do, though. You can learn that at home.
Yeah, but I'm not good at learning. I'm I have to be taught in a certain way to learn things. And as of right now, I haven't found a right way to be taught how to code.
How do you learn best? Visually? Audibly? Reading? Demonstration? Being asked questions?
A combination of demonstration and repetitiveness.
Yeah.
I mean, it's on one of the, like, many things that I want to do.
Mm-hmm.
I just have to, like, get around to figuring out the best way of doing it, I guess.
Mm-hmm. I'm the same way, Jeremy. I cannot read something and retain it as knowledge. I can't do it. I have to be shown, like, through a demonstration, or I need to learn with my eyes. I need to be shown, like, graphics and graphs and, you know what I mean? I need, like, visual aid in order to learn, or at very least audio. But the concept of reading a book, retaining the knowledge, look at this graph, and being able to learn something just through text only is not my thing. I can't. But everybody learns differently. If you ever think you're stupid, you're probably not. You probably just learn differently, is all. This is a PSA from me. Right.
I don't think I'm stupid. I have, like, a lot of useless knowledge.
That's an autism superpower, that is.
Yeah. I really do think I'm autistic, but at this point in life, I ain't going to go and get checked out.
Yeah. Let's see. What has been the highlight of your year? Well, the year's only just got started. But honestly?
Do we do the highlight of last year?
Well, do the last year since last April. Honestly, getting 1,000 followers, not even kidding, not even joking or anything. Starting streaming, growing into a streamer, learning how to properly stream, as proper as I get anyway, what with all my scuff. And honestly, yes, 1,000 followers. That was the highlight of my year, I think. What about you, Kat?
The highlight of my year was not ending myself.
That's always a good goal to have.
Yeah. Other than that, my life is pretty mid.
Mid. Didn't you graduate uni in the last year? Or was that 2 years ago?
No, that was a while ago now.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. That is an achievement, though. I was proud to do that.
Surely something else has happened to you.
I mean, I got a good job, but then I lost it. Complicated.
Not his fault, company's fault.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cat hit LR4. You did. You hit LR4.
I guess that's an achievement in some way.
Of course it is.
Yeah.
Cat's best achievement is dealing with you guys.
Yeah.
Also, did you eat the cherry off of my pudding?
I did. It was tasty.
Where did it go?
I ate it.
Holy shit. Oh my god. Vormar. Bobbies, thank you so much. Holy shit, let's go. Holy crap.
Biggie bitty titty committee.
Biggie bitty titty committee. Biggie bitty. Biggie titty. Oh, Bubs, thank you so much. That is so sweet of you. Trying to steal Winston's visit. You are so good to me. Thank you so, so much. You're amazing. Thank you. Maybe I'll get that goal of making minimum wage from streaming after all. You guys are fantastic. This is so great. Who said it? Was it War that said it? It's all my regulars that are here. Like the people that are here, not for the Warframe streams or the giveaways. Yeah. Like these are my regulars. It's a chill stream with my regulars and I quite like it. I actually really do. I don't even care about like numbers or anything like that. This is really nice to just hang out with the people that are usually here. Never gonna win. One day, War. One day. All right. Where am I now? If you could trade places with anyone for a week, who would it be? Go on.
Oh, you're asking me first?
Yeah.
Sorry, I was looking up at the light trying to sneeze. You know when you like really need to sneeze? And it just won't come.
I mean relatable.
Your sneeze is a little further south.
There was a bit like that. Was it? It was in a show, I think. Oh no, it was in Friends. Yes, it was in Friends, wasn't it? He's like, I felt something in the shower, and he was talking about like a pimple or something that he had. And then the other guy goes, was it like a sneeze, only better? I love it. Yeah, go ahead, Kat.
I've forgotten the question. What was the question?
If you could trade places with anybody for a week, who would it be?
Oh, see, now we have done this. We did this on the Valentine stream, and I came up with an answer that was
clipped.
Clipped and somewhat popular, it would seem. Popular opinion.
Uh-huh.
However, I will choose a different topic for this one.
Mm-hmm. You did, Clay.
So, like, the whole thing with, like, most people would choose someone rich, okay?
Hmm.
They'd choose someone rich because they would, like, I don't know, send their real self some money or mm-hmm. whatever, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. something like that. I find that answer very common.
Mm-hmm.
And I think what I would do is more target sort of an experience than trying to make my own life better.
Mm-hmm.
And I think, I mean, it's been a huge dream, and I'm sure it's a dream for many people, is to go to space.
Ooh.
So I think I would try and trade lives with someone maybe on the ISS or something like that.
And the International Space Station.
That's what it stands for.
Uh-huh.
And see what space is like.
That would be really cool.
I could be a space cat.
Space cat! Aww. Have you ever seen those videos of the experiment that they did with cats in zero gravity?
No. I've seen the dog.
What? Because you know how if you have a cat and you pick it up by its feet and it's upside down and then you let it go, it'll land on its feet because they have that center of gravity thing. So if you have a cat in zero gravity and you let it go, it just kind of freaks out. Look it up right now. I know you can alt tab. Go look it up. The cats in zero gravity experiment.
I mean, I can look it up on my phone.
Do that. You can look like you're sleeping while I rant. For a week, yeah? Okay. I have a multi-layered answer for this one. I was going to say, oh yeah, I'd like to trade lives with someone rich and wire myself some money. And yeah, but Kat kind of shat on my answer. Let's see. I would want to trade lives with one of those, like, you know, those monks that like live in the mountains and they have like achieved absolute peace of mind. You know what I mean? Like the ones that like have achieved this like higher plane of understanding and are able to completely relax and completely be at peace in their own mind. I want that. I want to understand. I want to understand what true peace feels like. Because I have lived with a baseline of almost intolerable anxiety for my whole life. So I want to know what absolute peace feels like. And if it doesn't have to be a person, I would like to be some kind of an apex predator of some kind. Like, I would like to trade lives with, like a falcon or a hawk or something and experience flight, not in the kind of way that I have as a pilot, but like with actual wings and feathers and flight. Or I'd like to be a shark and I would like to experience what it's like to swim in the water and things like that. Okay. Cat. Talk about cats in zero gravity while I drink.
It looks like they're breakdancing. I don't know whether they like it or not. They kind of just like wobble around. They're wobbling.
They wobble and they wiggle and they jiggle. Where is my cherry? Legit, you ate it. It's gone.
It did.
Jiggle, jiggle, jiggle. Jiggle, jiggle, jiggle. Jiggle, jiggle. Every day I'm wobbling. What is your proudest accomplishment? A compliment? The fuck? Accomplishment. Let's see. Well, getting my pilot's license was one. Living until 34 is another. That's an accomplishment. Yes, yes. Getting my psych degree. That was a good one. Outliving my mother. That's a good one. That's a real good one. Because she was awful to me. And when your mother dies and she tortured you your whole life, you can sit there and say, you know what? You know what? Who really won in the end? Yes, your girl is a general aircraft pilot. Psych degree, pilot's license. I mean, living in many countries, I think that's pretty cool. I think it's pretty cool to be able to tell stories about living in several countries and having a very rich life and things like this. That's nice. My streaming career. I'm very proud of my streaming career. Having over 1,000 followers in 9 months is really something to me. That means something to me. What else? I think that's it. That's at least the big ones. How about you, Kat? What is your biggest accomplishment?
Yeah. What?
Your biggest accomplishment. Or your proudest?
Probably getting a first class honors degree.
For our not British audience, can you explain what that means?
I thought that's a universal term, no?
It is not. You had to explain that to me.
It's, but you, I, do you, what?
Do you guys not have bachelor's?
Do you guys not have bachelor's degrees?
We do, but what you're talking about, first class honors, that's not what we have. We have like valedictorian, magna cum laude.
Well, what's like the top one?
Valedictorian.
Well, it's just that then, I guess.
Yes. He was top of his class, is what he's saying. Go on then.
Well, that's my proudest accomplishment.
That's it? Smart.
What else? What else am I proud of? Oh, not dying in my teenage years, I guess.
Oh?
Yeah.
Cat, yeah, I'm smart.
We don't really go there.
Is this from an injury or other things?
All right, I've had many injuries, but it's from other things.
Okay, we'll leave that at that. You were a rowdy child. Aww.
I was a child of the streets.
Yeah, okay. I like this one. What is your biggest pet peeve? I like this one a lot. Do you know that sound that some people make when they chew? When it's like wet? No, stop. I will mute you. No. I will legitimately mute you. Anyway, people that when they eat, like, crunching is okay. There's nothing wrong with like dry crunching. I can listen to chewing, but it's when it's like wet and smacky and I can like hear your saliva. No. Mm-mm. No, I go into a blind fit of rage. I am a very level-headed, calm, logical person, but there is something about when I yes, exactly, Jeremy, when your mouth sounds like what good pussy sounds like. No, I can't. It's absolutely terrible, and I go into an actual rage.
She like legit hates spending time with me.
I legitimately cannot be in the same room and eat as this man, this cat. I actually can't. It's really bad. What about you, Kat? What's your pet peeve? You are a pet, so you should have many peeves.
Obnoxious people, I guess. I don't know. Loud people.
Oh, so you don't like me then?
People.
People, yeah. Pet peeve of people, yes. Just, people are horrible.
I just don't like people, really.
Yeah.
Pet peeves.
Hmm.
There's a certain way that British people pronounce certain words that is a real pet peeve of mine.
Ooh, I want to hear this one.
I can't do it. Because it's not like programmed into me. I can't physically do it.
Tuna.
Well, no, these are all normal.
Right. What words are you speaking of then?
I can't do it.
Well, what's the word?
Well, there's multiple. It's just a way of saying stuff. I can't do it. I wish I could explain it, but I can't. It's a certain way of saying vowels, and it's just horrible.
Is it a certain British accent?
No.
Uh-uh.
I've okay. only known a few people that have done it.
Mm-hmm.
And I hate them all.
What a proper cat. I really like this one. Are you ready for this one? I really like this one. Shout out to Winston. If you had a warning label, what would it say? Unstable substance.
Volatile.
Wide load. Toxic. Mental health nightmare. Keep out of reach of children. Warning, tits often broken. Fragile, handle with care. Oh, Clay, that's too real. That's too real. Clay calling me out like this. How about you, Kat? What's your warning label?
Mine's just volatile.
Return to sender. My manufacturer no longer exists. I don't have warranty. Doesn't play well with others. Scares easily.
Mine's probably
May bites.
Not compatible with children.
Yeah. Keep out of reach of children.
Yeah.
Okay. We're getting through. What is one thing that you tried and you'll never do again?
Horse riding.
I remember that day that you came home from horseback riding and you called me and you told me about the pain that you were experiencing and where.
My and gooch hurt for days. Weeks even.
Oh.
It's not even like a ball pain because your balls just kind of flop around with it no matter what. It's fine because you're not landing on your balls particularly. But that area, the gooch area and like the insides of your thighs, I felt like I was walking with like a wooden plank in between my legs and like... God, it was rough.
Oh. I don't claim to understand that pain, but that sounds like it's rough. What's something that I have done that I will never do again? Men.
Adopt a cat.
I am a dog person from here on out. Someone call Slimy. I don't know. Because I see it as everything that you could possibly have regrets for in your life, you learn lessons from them. So even
ate Carolina Reaper.
You ate Carolina Reaper?
Yeah, that's something that we won't be doing again.
What happened?
Fucking shit my ass at 4 o'clock in the morning whilst working at fucking a packaging company that has a name and is global.
You could say that here because that's what's Twitch.
Well, Amazon owns Twitch. No, they don't.
Why do you think you could pay for a sub with Prime?
I didn't know that.
What?
I used to work for Amazon. No, I didn't know that.
No, if you have Amazon Prime, you could sub to a streamer once a month for free.
Oh.
Azura always gets mine because I have Prime. No, yeah, I would perish. I have a very sensitive mouth and I can't handle spicy stuff like at all. What is with this pudding? Look at it. It's imitating my boobs. Look at it go. Damn. Bezo bucks. I find this question difficult. Because I like to learn from my regrets rather than saying like, ah, shit, I'll never do that again. My boobs are imitating the pudding.
Well, have you not done anything that you regret?
Well, going back to that good girl syndrome, I have a mentality where I try to think 16 steps ahead so that I don't have regrets. You know what I mean?
I have plenty, but I can't say them on stream, I'm afraid.
Let's see. I don't think I have one like that, you know? Not off the top of my head, anyway. Cat, you're getting pets. Yeah. What is your favorite thing about your career? You guys. You guys. I love talking to chat, even though I'm not that great at it because I'm like horribly dyslexic. So reading quickly and accurately is really not something that I'm very good at. And I apologize endlessly for not always being able to read everybody's messages. And it's even harder when I have to do the split focus thing, like when I'm trying to play a game and read chat at the same time. But even though I'm not very good at it, I love talking to chat. Like, you guys are so sweet and so good to me. And overall, just a lot of fun to hang out with. Like, you guys are super chill. Like, the Warframe community really brought me my people. I'm not even kidding. Like, that's not even like complimenting chat because they support me kind of a thing. Like, you guys are actually legitimately awesome and I love you. And I would hang out with you guys in real life. Seriously. If I ever met one of yous on the street, we would go for a coffee. Horny is a personality and that's perfectly acceptable. Absolutely. Coffee. What about you, Kat?
I mean, I have many careers.
Mm-hmm. Well, what's your favorite thing about all of them?
Well, each one's kind of different.
Mm-hmm.
My day job, I get to boss people about, I guess.
Nice, nice.
My other day job, I love everything about it.
Mm-hmm.
You
have another day job?
I get to make advances in technology and such.
Oh, I see.
And my other side day job, I get to build stuff.
Ooh.
Which is always very satisfying. And I'm good at it, so.
Where's my cat box for cat cam?
I'm a very handy cat.
A handy cat.
Handy cat.
Handy cat. This next one I am going to leave entirely for cat. Ready? Oh. Do you eat or drink soup?
But that's a trick question.
Go on.
Like, if I'm eating soup, I'm like doing it with a spoon.
Uh-huh.
But if I'm drinking soup, I'm drinking out of a mug.
Uh-huh.
So it can be both. Fight me.
Cat's like, I will die on this hill. It depends on the soup. Like, if you have just like a broth, broth. I can't even.
Yeah, but I feel like if you're still doing it with a spoon, it's an eat.
No, a fork is an eat.
Like, eat and drink are actions, yeah?
Yeah.
So, like, the action of drinking, what do? You drink out of a cup or a glass or a mug or something. Well, whereas the action when you eat, you do it with utensils like a fork or a knife or a spoon. Or, well, wait.
No, because I could put my water in a bowl and drink it. I wouldn't maybe be then eating my water.
That would be really weird. Why would you do that?
To prove a point. It's if it's a really liquidy soup like a broth, then you're drinking it. But if it's like a chunky soup with like chunky bits in it, like chicken or noodles or something like that, then you're eating it almost like a stew.
Yeah, but like, is a broth really a soup?
Well, yeah, like chicken broth is a soup. You can have just chicken soup.
Like, what does the word soup mean?
Well, go on and Google it.
What is soup?
What is soup?
Soup. A liquid dish, typically savory and made with boiling meat, fish, or vegetables.
Huh.
The waves and the water beyond have become thick brown soup.
So, it's boiled meat. The liquid from a boiled meat. So that's something you drink.
Okay, let's just say that you drink the liquid part of soup and you eat the solid part of soup.
Exactly
that's
what
the,
I
that's
said.
That's the most scientific way of looking at it.
That's how I see it.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you step on cracks in the sidewalk or step over them?
I'm not superstitious. Is it superstitious?
That is a superstition, yes.
Yeah, I'm not superstitious like that.
It's an OCD thing for me.
I've walked under enough ladders and broken enough mirrors to give me bad luck for more years than I'm going to live, so it's fine.
But you're a black cat.
Why, do you want me to walk in front of you?
Go for it. Fuck it, let's go. If I'm paying attention to it, I typically don't. I have life altering OCD. Help me. And then I think the other two questions we've already answered. Why is cat when clearly not am cat? Why are you cat when not am cat? We've already answered this one. And then why do I ask so many questions when you're tired? He wasn't tired. He was just looking down, so it looked like he was sleeping. And that's all the questions we have.
I'm always tired.
Yeah, relatable. Always tired. And this was nice because I kind of wanted to do a 2-hour stream anyway, so we only went a tiny bit over. Are there any last-minute questions in chat that did not get covered? I'm not even going to try, Winston. I am not even going to try. I could not possibly. The sky is blue because it's the farthest-reaching spectrum color, and it reflects the ocean.
Why, what's the last question?
Pronounce the word that's in the Discord that Winston posted under AMA for stream.
Is this a real word?
Winston, is this a real word? I'm gonna say yes.
Drona dam vishika skelizikten achu petris de burka bounta baim ten gestaft.
Nice. Well done.
Where's my $5?
If you donate the $5, then I'll go buy nuggies and give Kat his nuggies for pronouncing the word. It's the longest word in the German language. What does it mean? What is it? Oh, of course I get an ad right at the end of stream. That's really nice. Let's see if anybody chill is on right now. Oh god, lag. Oh good lord, alt tabbing is not it.
I have to wonder what that word means though, or whether it's like a place name or something. Sometimes they have place names that are like super long. Like that place in Wales.
Oh, what is it? Is it a bridge?
It's a bridge. No, it's not a bridge. It's a place.
Is it like a town?
Yeah.
Cat finally got his nugs.
Chicken nugget fund.
You finally get some nugs, Cat, because you pronounced a really hard German word.
Depends if you send it to me or not.
You live right down the street.
She withholds all my funds.
All right, I'm gonna start a little raid. All right. So this is a new person that I like, who is a Warframe streamer who actually has a pretty similar model to mine, really. Right. So thank you everybody for being here. I appreciate you. It seems like it's all my regulars as well. So I'm super excited that you guys were all here. I love that you joined me for my just chatting stream and that I got to have all my regulars here. You guys are amazing. Thank you so much for posting all of your excellent questions. I'm so excited. Send proof of nuggies. I will send receipt of nuggie. Lots of love back to you, Zach, and the rest of chat. Thank you so much. I love you guys. Your support is everything in the whole world to me. So I will see you back here, and we're going back to Warframe Monday. Monday, and we'll have new stuff, new giveaways. I think there's one more week of drops, if I'm not mistaken. There might be one more. I'm not sure. And I hope to see you guys all there. So have a very good one and have an excellent weekend. Stay in touch in the Discord. Good night, everybody. Night.
Bye-bye.